Azeb cleared TMP exam with all above target, with overall above target. His PMP journey has been amazing. He joined our batch program and cleared PMP exam with flying color. He did exam in the center. So let's hear from Shazeb for his journey. Shazeb, tell us everything you could about exam, everything you can, then I'll ask questions.
Assalamu alaikum. First of all, I would like to introduce myself. I am Muhammad Shazeb Anil. As per my qualification, I am basically in background, I am a mechanical engineer. And as per my journey in PMP, as a PMP certification, I started my journey in batch one of Amir Ali. We start from 15th of January. I would like to thankful to my Allah, Alhamdulillah, by the grace of Allah and prayers of my parents, my friends, and especially my mentor, Mr. Amir Ali, who helped me in every aspect from my planning, coaching, each and everything, just like Tuckman ladder. he developed me in every sense, from forming to adjourning stage. He helped me in every aspect to achieve my milestone, which he helped me a lot in everything. As per my journey, I began my journey from 15th of January 2021. At first, I would like to add one more thing about who referred me to Mr. Amir Ali. One of my friends, which is my classmate from university of which is my friend of from university who cleared PMP in last December 2020. I asked him to please help me to which mentor I have to select. He said to me, if you want to clear your PMP, then please go to the Amir Ali. He's the best in the town. He just say simple in one line. He said, he's the best in the town if you want to clear this. So on the same day, at almost 9 p.m., as per PST time, Pakistan Standard Time, I make a call to Mr. Amir. He guide me how to create and help me how to. At first, he introduced me about the PMP. What is PMP? I don't know about the PMP. I just hear the name of PMP. What is PMP? He's just a project manager certification. I just know that. Then he asked me to join first batch number one, which starts from 2021 in 15 January. I enrolled myself in the batch number one, and then my classes conducted for almost, it almost took 6 to 7 days. We have 3 days, 2 to 3 days for agile and 3 to 4 days for predictive. At this time, I don't know what is PMP. At first, I don't know what is the difference between predictive and agile. I don't know. So he helped me, he mentored me in every aspect to clear this journey. I started training. I would like to add one more thing. I think I have done every mocks which is in the I think which is present in the PMP field. And in my first exam, I have taken just 54% mocks, which is the mock of Mr. Amir Ali, 6 mocks. And then I have done second one. My percentage is almost 56, 57 tier, no more than 60. Then we have made a coaching call, one-on-one session. He helped me how to tackle the problems, what are my obstacles. He helped me in every aspect. Then day by day, I done my learning along with my job. I have given 4 to 5 hours per day, and it took me almost 2 to 3 months to clear this milestone. And I have done PMP in, I think, Thursday on 3rd of 3rd of June 2021. Alhamdulillah, I have taken all about targets in every field.
So that's a great summary of everything Shahzeb has just said. I would like to put something in the context that Shahzeb said it, but I would like to reiterate. Shahzeb has actually done all the mocks in the market. So Shahzeb, kudos to you. Like the commitment this guy has, the reason, you see, when your why is clear, everything becomes easy. His why was so clear that I want to become PMP. I am willing to do hard work as much as it takes. Yes, my sport was there, my pushing was there, and also sometime my anger was there. But at the end of the day, he was the person who was doing mock. Like he did all Tri-Day, all Andrew Ramdial, all UDEM, all Workday, my mock, prepcast 2 times. I don't know how many random prepcast I have given him, but he kept on doing. And that's the bottom line. Consistency beat talent. As he said, in the first mock, he got 54%. In the last mock, when he gave exam, he got 85.7. From 54 to 85.7, before going to exam, this was simply one thing. Extreme hard working. Whatever you want to say, that is simply the basis of what I have seen Shahzeb. Shahzeb, by profession, is a mechanical engineer and he is working in power plants. Now the power plants people, he's in operation and maintenance, right, Shahzeb?
Yes, sir. Operation and maintenance of power plant.
So he's a very hard-working guy. Sometime at 1 a.m. I call him and he said, I said, you haven't updated me that about mock. He said, sir, power plant has shut down. I am working on it. So a very hard worker. Where students can take 2 weeks off and can do those things. He was a person who said that, sir, I cannot take a day off. He only take a day off for his exam. And even today, it's not just about one thing. Like I wanted to record the journey 15 minutes before because I got free. I called him, Shahzeb said, I am playing badminton. Let me play my game, then we can record it. Like the consistency, the level of focus. He's focused on health. He's focused on his job. He's focused on his study. He's focused on his family. Now the whole domain is focused. That is the definition of a champion. Let me put something in the context. During when our PMP training was going on peak, like we were thinking to give PMP exam in a week or 10 days, he went for a trip. He went for a family trip to the beautiful northern areas, Azad Kashmir. Like he never told me. For me, he was doing mock. Then I saw his WhatsApp status. He is in the Sharda. He is in Neelam Valley. I asked him, hey Shahzeb, what about mock? He said, sir, can I get 2-3 days off? I'm busy with family. Now I knew where he was. I could see his status. But the thing is that that guy balanced the overall domain. That's how we need to do in our life. We need to take care of everything. You need to clarify that everything is there for you. Just not focus one thing and be obsessive about it. Yes, sometimes PMP demands obsession. Yes, yes, everything is yes. But consistency is the number one key, which has proven for Shahzeb in last in his PMP exam. So Shahzeb, I always ask all my aspirants, before moving forward, I want to ask few things about the exam. How many exam was agile? How much predictive? Which area were more focused?
Sir, almost 50 to 60% paper have agile, and 20 to 25% almost hybrid, and 20 to 25% almost predictive. In predictive, there is no tough questions. Mostly questions tough in people domain are from agile. There are four type of answers in as per your technique, elimination technique, which I used in every question in the exam. I have eliminated almost every question. I almost eliminated two answers, and I have to choose it is difficult to eliminate two choices, which is better on, and I have to choose better or best one. So it is so much difficult to choose the best one.
Okay.
In different questions, our teacher, instructor asks to, what is the next step? And the second, he said, what do product manager have to do in this situation? So it is difficult to select which is the best option.
Okay, that is a great thing to understand how you are moving with this way. What is the next, what is the difficult option, what to move along the way. So which area was more targeted, Shazib? Stakeholder, communication, resource, which area were more targeted?
Sir, I have almost in question, more questions are from procurement, 2 to 3 questions from procurement, 2 to 3 questions from risk, almost in risk techniques, mostly risk I have taken techniques, which strategy you have to choose. We have to create a differentiate between strategies, escalate so much different strategies, which is in the risk plan, risk response. From stakeholder, almost 2 to 3 questions from stakeholder, and scope I have taken 2 to 3, and 1 or 2 from CPA, and 2 from I think schedule. One from deliverable journey.
Okay.
If I remember.
So almost everything.
Yes, almost.
Okay.
In agile, just we have your videos are really enough. Not more than I think instructor or a paper selector does not use XP, does not take questions from these. Just agile principles, values, and Scrum methodology. Just enough for the exam.
That's a very good thing. Agile principles and all those things. So talking about, did you take 2 breaks? There were 2 breaks in the exam. Have you taken the breaks?
Yes, sir. There are 2 breaks. Yes, sir. Almost I have divided the whole 231 minutes into 3 sections. For 60 questions, I have taken almost 72-75 minutes, 6 to 7 minutes for review. Almost 60 questions I have done in 65 minutes, almost. And then 5 to 10 minutes for a review, which I have marked flag. Then I have taken 5 to 6, first break I have taken is 7 minutes. And I have just prayed to Allah in total 6 minutes, totally in just 6 minutes, just prayed to Allah, nothing done, anything else, and just to relax my mind. And then after 7 minutes, I have started my next 60 questions. Then after 60 questions, it took me almost 60 to 65 minutes. I have taken this for next 60 questions. Then after 120 questions, I have taken almost 8 to 10 minutes, break. 8 to 9 minutes, sorry, break. After 8 to 9 minutes, I have done remaining 60 questions. Almost I have completed my task before 10 to 15 minutes. And then I have used these minutes for review of last 60 questions.
Before 10 to 15 minutes. Now that's a great achievement, my friend, that you completed the exam, not just before time, but you have 10 to 15 minutes ahead. Now that's a great thing to know for the exam that, okay, any question on critical path or formulas?
Sir, from formulas, I question are basically 2 from a CPA and 1 from, it means to say total, there are 2 questions from cost, 1 from CPA and SPA, and a second one for, I think, from cost, plan cost management, I think, from this. And second one, you have said from
critical path.
Critical path, almost I have just not so much sure I have taken, I have faced such a question.
Okay, that makes sense. Okay,
I don't know.
It's been 4 or 5 days, so of course you don't remember everything about the exam, so that does make sense. Okay, so Shazib, you have given us a lot of information. One minute, one advice that you will give to all aspirants, all future aspirants, what they should do.
Sir, I think at first as per my opinion, at first we have to just believe on Allah at first, second one patience, and third your advice. I think three are the main things for the achievement of BMP. I have done just three things, not more than this. I think it's enough.
Thank you, Shazir. Thank you very much for your kind interview, and I wish you best of luck. And let's see how you can utilize. Now the next step is to use this PMP certification for the better use, the reason for you did. Now, Shazir, moving forward, one thing I would like to know. You mentioned your friend who cleared PMP in 2020. Who cleared it? You never told me.
Sir, it is not enrolled in your, he's not enrolled in your batch. He just advised me, if he just use your videos from, he has just taken your videos for clear of PMP. Just use your videos to clear the PMP.
Do I know him?
Sorry?
Do I know him?
No, sir. You don't know.
Okay. Thank you very much, Shazir.
No, sir. You don't know.
Thank you, Shazir. Thank you very much for your time. And I wish you best of luck, and best of luck in badminton also. Okay, Shazir. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. Hello YouTube, what's up? It's Amir Ali here. Thank you very much for watching this video. I am so grateful that you watched this video, and I hope now it has added value into your PMP journey. If you have any question at any time, you can ask me on this number or email me. I would love to answer you. And if you have not subscribed, please click the subscription button so that I can help you in a better way. My commitment to YouTube is going to increase. I'm going to upload more coaching calls, more journeys, and more posts. So do join this journey and become certified PMP in less time.